Hello. In this video, I'm going to talk about action potentials, which is a change in voltage within body cells. Specifically, it involves what's known as a depolarization event. That's when a cell gets more positive than its resting state, and a repolarization event when it returns back to its resting state. Okay, so one thing we've talked about in previous videos is that a resting cell has a voltage, a difference in charge between the outside and the inside of the cell. The inside of the cell is negative, and that charge is generally about negative 70 to negative 90 millivolts. For this video, we'll suggest it's negative 70 millivolts, which we see down here. The y-axis here is in millivolts, and the x-axis is in time. And if we take a look at this, all this scene or slide is showing right here is that this is the resting state. So during an inactive state, excitable cells have a resting membrane potential. Just like I've been suggesting, -70 to -90 millivolts. And I didn't use the term excitable. All cells in our body have a voltage across their membrane, but they are only able to become excited or have a change in voltage if they are permeable to ions that will induce some sort of change in their electrical state. So that change, more often than not, is due to the influx of sodium into that cell. And that change is what's known as a depolarization. I should say, when a cell becomes more positive inside than its resting state, that's a depolarization. So if we think back to previous videos, at the resting state, we've suggested that the interior of the cell is negative and the exterior of the cell is positive. And that's polarized because it has two different ends of the spectrum between the outside and the inside of the cell. That is to say, positive and negative, just like a battery, which is polar. So during depolarization, the interior of the cell becomes positive. So we call it depolarized because in theory, the outside is positive and the inside is positive. Full disclosure, I don't totally agree with that because the outside does become less positive. And even some books will show it becoming negative and the inside positive. And to me, that's not depolarized. That's just flipping the state of polarization. But forget what I just said about that. So we'll suggest that positive charge coming in makes the interior of the cell positive, which we see right here at roughly 30 millivolts. More often than not, that's due to the influx of sodium into cells. It could be the influx of calcium into cells. And it theoretically could also be the efflux of an anion out of cells. But more often than not, it's sodium influx into the cell. Now, cells, if they want to continually depolarize, they need to repolarize first. That is to say, if a cell is going to depolarize numerous times, and depolarization events are important because they allow for continued further activity downstream in that cell. That is to say, some sort of metabolic processes are going to result from the depolarization event. So cells always want to be, or I shouldn't say always, cells like to return to the resting state so they can depolarize again. So cells that have depolarized must first repolarize before they depolarize again. And that's what we see here. Deep repolarization events generally occur due to potassium efflux, or the movement of potassium down its gradient out of the cell. So one thing I may not have suggested during the depolarization event, that sodium moving down its gradient into the cell for repolarization is potassium moving down its gradient out of the cell, because as we've suggested previously, there's always a higher concentration of potassium inside cells than outside cells. As positive charge leaves the cell, that cell starts becoming more negative again as it's losing positive charge. And then eventually it will make it back to the resting state, as we see right here. And that is an action potential. An action potential is a depolarization and repolarization event. There's some additional characteristics that we may see in action potentials, such as a hyperpolarization event. But for now, we're just going to stick with the basics of a depolarization and repolarization event that occurs in excitable cells. Depolarization, more often than not, is due to the influx of sodium into cells. The repolarization is due to the efflux of potassium out of cells. That's it for now. Stay tuned for the next video.